it was nice for me because it was just me feeling Amy's here.
Right. Yeah, feeling her presence still there.
Yes, absolutely.
Because it's fascinating, absolutely fascinating. Yes. You do feel at the end of the book that you know who she is.
Yes.
You know, you actually know her then.
Yeah, good.
And look at these, the photographs in there are fantastic. Choosing those though and looking at her, you know, there's letters from her in the book, yes, and things like that. And going through all of that, you just, I mean, I'm interested to find out that you actually found that comforting.
Yes, definitely. It's reassuring.
And to see, you know, to see what she was like growing up. Really interestingly, we actually had Tony Bennett on the show,
right,
last week. And obviously Tony and Amy worked together.
Yes.
And he was so, well, listen to this. This is what he had to say about your girl.
That lady was really one of the true great jazz singers of all time. I met her mom and she said, you know, I feel a little different about her. From the minute she was born, she wanted to become famous as an entertainer. Right. Her wish came true.
It certainly did.
Yes.
So, as a little girl, was she always kind of performing, singing?
Yes, constantly at home, constantly singing. And we had to say, shut up, Amy.
So it was just all the
constant.
Time?
Constant.
All the time, all the time.
Yes.
And you know, you've had your battles too, because as we know,
yes,
you've got MS.
Yes.
And that must have been very, very difficult for you to deal with what was happening to you as well as what was happening to your daughter.
Yes, definitely was. Where as a mother, I stepped back. I didn't want to worry her.
Yeah.
I never wanted to worry her.
Sure. So you couldn't really share with her
how
you were feeling?
Oh, no.
When you watched, it was interesting, you say this, yes, in the book, which I find very interesting, was the fact that when you saw her, there was one moment when you saw her on television,
yes,
and it was like she was being this person who,
yes,
was Amy Winehouse,
yes,
but she wasn't really being your Amy.
No.
It had grown larger than life.
Absolutely, yes, that's true. Because she was like, again, we see the performer. She,
yes,
was in the performance.
Mm. When did you know, Janis, that something was wrong, that she wasn't coping?
Well, it's something that that you had an awareness, something not right.
Yeah.
But you don't know what.
And did you, I mean, obviously you found,
yeah,
out she was drinking too much and the drug,
yes,
problems were happening. And it's very clear in the book that you tried so hard. You tried everything.
Absolutely,
that you possibly,
yes,
could. It must,
yes,
have been so difficult.
Because there's nothing you can do, because you're watching it.
Yeah.
And as much as one would say, don't do that, Amy did it.
Mm. And you couldn't really do anything about it.
No.
I remember vividly, Janis, when I interviewed her, she came on here, it was back in the days of GMTV, and I think it was when she was still married.
Right.
And she was painfully thin.
Yes.
I mean, like, scarily thin,
oh, yes,
actually. And you must have seen that change in her physically.
Yes, and that was upsetting. But it's also that feeling of, I cannot do anything because I'm watching it, but if I were to say anything, she would say, don't worry, Mum, don't,
yeah,
worry.
Because that was the thing, she was always kind of like, no, everything's fine.
No, yes, absolutely.
She was really,
yes,
in,
yes,
she was really in denial,
yeah,
about,
oh,
that.
Yes.
She would say, no, I'm fine, everything's fine.
Oh, yeah, don't worry, Mum, don't worry. She would always apologise, bless her. Whenever she was drinking, she'd be saying, I'm sorry, Mummy. You know, I hope you don't mind. She'd be smoking in the early days. Oh, I'm sorry, Mummy. Are you OK? I'm sorry, Mummy.
Yeah, so she would be apologising to
all
you all the time.
But, yes,
at the same time, not changing,
yes,
her,
absolutely,
habits,
yes,
which is so, so hard. When was the last time you saw her and what was she like when you saw her?
Well, the good thing was I saw her the day before.
Right.
But it's, who'd have known?
Hmm. And was she OK then? Was she in reasonable?
No. Not really, no.
No. But you didn't feel that when you saw her that day that something terrible
exactly
would happen?
No, exactly. No. No, I didn't.
There was no indication that there was.
No,
but you must,
not.
I mean, you say that you've got this situation where you thought, you over the years, especially towards the end, that you might lose her.
Yes. It was often the way that I thought, this may be the last.
Yeah.
But thank God I said on that day, I love you, Amy.
Oh, that's.
And she said to me, I love you, Mummy.
So that's the memory.
Oh, absolutely, yes.
That at least you've got that comfort.
Oh, yes,
because how,
yes,
awful it would have been if it had ended
for sure
in an argument or something.
No.
But you were able to tell
each other. But we were always loving.
Hmm.
Always.
No, you are very much so. And her legacy does live on.
Yes.
It really does. And I know that you're very, very involved with the foundation.
Yes.
Oh, and yes. How do you want her to be remembered?
As people remember her as, like, a great singer.
Mm, like Tony Bennett said.
Absolutely,
best
yes.
jazz singer of her generation.
Yes, absolutely, yes.
And that, you know, you get Tony Bennett saying that. That's
yeah,
pretty
I know.
Good, isn't
He's
it?
He's a sweetie, yes.
Yeah, absolutely. But you're very involved with raising funds too.
Yes.
And how does the foundation help people?
Well, it's in various ways, where it has different sections. And the most important thing it does is the resilience programme, which relates to children and young people with addictions.
Right, and it helps them.
Oh, yes.
It helps them.
Yes, it's there for them.
Which is fantastic. It
Absolutely.
Really is. I think you're amazing because you cope with MS and
yes.
you cope with it incredibly well because it's
yes.
a really... It's a horrible condition, isn't
yes.
it? It's a horrible condition. But when I said to you, when we were sitting
yes.
down, I said to Janice, do you have good days and bad days? And you said, no, I just have good days.
Yes, absolutely.
That's the way that you look in life.
Oh, for sure, yes. I'm one who takes life and says, yes, it's a good one. And I love it.
You're amazing.
Yes.
Thank you very much indeed.
Well,
and if you want to know what Amy Winehouse was yes. really, really like, then this book will tell you. It's Loving Amy, A Mother's Story, and it's out now. Janice, thank you.
Well, thank you.
Indeed.